What is DTC high performance? Well, the USTA defines high performance as your top 100 in the country nationally ranked in your first year in your age group, or your top 50 in the country nationally ranked your second year in your age group. If those are your criteria, then you're considered a high performance player. We take a different approach to that here at DTC, whereas we believe that if you're striving to be the best tennis player you can be, we consider you to be a high performance player. If you're willing to work on your strokes, your control, your power, your point structure, your match play, you play the right tournaments to qualify for level one nationals, you're willing to work on your conditioning, you're willing to work on your mental game, then we consider you to be high performance at the Darling Tennis Center. Here we really work on all facets of the game, and we truly believe in growing our players from total beginners in the Pee Wee program at the age of 5, all the way to getting a college scholarship at the age of 18. We have programs for kids of all ages and all aspirations. But the ones that are selected for high performance are the ones that are trying to qualify for level one nationals and are willing to do basically whatever it takes to get there. That's what we define as high performance. Our high performance coaches here are trained and experienced to work with kids of all ages. Our under 10 high performance is called the Futures Program, and we work a lot on how to move on the court with them, the athletic base with them. We work a lot on stroke production and consistency with them. Other stages of development, we move on, they graduate onto the Challenger Program. The Challenger Program kids are probably playing at a sectional level. They could be aged anywhere from 10 to 16 years of age. There we work a lot on point structure, controls. We work a lot on how to put a match together, how to compete. We start working a lot on the mental side of the game. If they do well there and we start seeing results at the national level, they graduate on to the master's program where they are probably playing at the level one national level and playing the level two nationals and all four of the level one nationals. So we do have kind of a rite of passage here at Darling. We believe it is not easy, but if the rite of passage is a little bit difficult, I believe the progress of the players is actually better. Your end result, your end player that you get at the age of 16, 17, 18 is going to be stronger, tougher, and more developed. When I say we work on all stages of development, we are trained really well here to teach the right things at the right stage of development. For example, a player that is 9 years old and plays 6 to 8 hours a week. We work a lot on their athletic base. We work a lot on touch and feel, not power, because the swing paths aren't in place yet and the muscles aren't in place yet. So we work a lot on the finesse shots. Whereas when a player is 14, that's when we start developing weapons, start working on power, start working on the big serve and things like that. So our high performance staff here is really well experienced and trained on what to teach and when to teach it. The windows of opportunity to teach a female player at the age of 10 to work on their feel and touch and finesse shots is the best time. If you do not work on those things, then you're going to miss the window of opportunity, and it's more difficult to teach it when they're 14, 15, or 16. So that's where I think we separate ourselves here at Darling from everybody else, is that our coaching staff is so well trained in what to teach and when to teach it. To elaborate a little bit further on what to work on and when to work on it with the kids, when to emphasize consistency, when to emphasize technique, when to work on power, when to work on leg drive on the serve. A lot of people talk about, you know, teach the pro stroke right away. And I kind of shy away from that, again, because a nine-year-old doesn't have the muscles in place as, say, a fully developed pro player or a fully developed college player or a fully developed 18-year-old national player. So you cannot teach them the same strokes. So you do have to build a stroke and work on stages of development. You do have to train the swing path so they are consistent with their swing path, and then work on power. Otherwise, they just make too many mistakes. They make a lot of unforced errors, and they probably will quit because they won't win too many matches making all those unforced errors. The culture that we're trying to create here for the kids is, our core values: determination, teamwork, and commitment. Those are our core values. It's like, stands for DTC, right? So, like Darling Tennis Center is also determination, teamwork, and commitment. Our kids here have a nice family atmosphere. They push each other. They encourage each other. When they would travel to tournaments, they cheer for each other during the matches. During practices, they encourage each other. If one player is getting down, the other player encourages them and tries to get them to play better tennis, to get in a better mood, and just, you know, get over the tough stages during practice. So we do have a good culture here of hard work and teamwork. We have a good culture here of kids that want to strive to become the best tennis players that they can become.